Hello everyone, this will be the review of game She Sees Red, and the key was provided by developer. The game is actually a movie where you can pick the next action of the hero. It's a literal movie with actors, and it's rather short. It takes something between 30 and 50 minutes, probably around 30 they say, but I have 50 minutes played, probably because I was idling a bit, per playthrough. But they say there is 80 minutes of footage, so if you count all the scenes and all the versions of the movie, all the sequences, because those scenes will form a sequence and will lead to one or the other ending, there is 80 minutes of material. That's what they say. For me, it was around 50 minutes to go through it once. So this is more an experience than a game. You do make a choice and you do see different scene, but this is pretty much a movie, which of course can have different versions, different endings, different results of your actions, but everything is cut into scenes. The problem is that you cannot rewind or fast forward the scenes and you can't skip them. So it's very nice in first contact when you play for the first time, but then when you want to replay and get all the endings, you would have to probably see a lot of the scenes again. So I think this should be fixed, at least make it like normal digital movie, so you can use all the options like on a recorder, rewinding back and forward and moving to next scene and maybe just skipping the whole section up to the point of choice, like in a visual novel. From what I checked, I think they said they won't do it because this is connected with some additional programming or something like that. But well, it's a bit annoying if you want to play more than once. For one playthrough, it was fun. I liked it, but I'm not sure if I want to just go through more cutscenes to see all the endings just for the sake of it. I'm kind of interested in all the rest of the scenes, but I definitely don't want to rewatch the same stuff again. And I would definitely have to. I would probably also have to keep track of what choices I make or play with some sort of guide in order to reach all the other endings and not end up with the same one, because that would just makes no sense to see the same scene more than once. There is a gallery in the game with a couple of pictures. Well, it's just photos from the making of the movie. But I won't be showing you them because that would be a spoiler to some extent. There's also a making of video. I will now have to turn on the voice because there is no sliders really. There's just one slider. And I will show you literally 30 seconds of the movie when it starts. So just the first 30 seconds. And then I will sum it up. So I won't be talking during the time, but I just want to show you first 30 seconds. So let's try to do it. We're going to, let's say, 50% voice. I'm gonna leave everything in English, including subtitles. I'm going back. Now it's not responding. No, it is. Okay. So new game and 30 seconds when we see some action. Okay. Oh, it's pausing. Oh yeah. All right. So I have to count it. Yeah, it always pauses when you go at top. So I have to just continue and kind of count to 30. So in a moment, I'll just count it, whatever. And then I will just stop it and we go back. Well, let's say no, because I want an achievement. Right? Yeah, that was weird because it went into credits and again I couldn't skip. So once more and I will say yes this time. Yeah, that's the problem. I cannot skip it. So I would like to fast forward or something. At least the choice, but no. Yeah, so it's a bit weird when you say no. Just film just ends. It's sort of a joke, but okay, let's start it. Okay, and 30 seconds. Thank you. Alright, that would be it, guys. I don't want to show you more, just to prove that this is actually a, well, it's a movie, right? So you can see the graphics, which is basically real live actors. And let me just go back to all the stuff here. Settings will be down, because otherwise we have music. Right, so this is a sort of action movie. It is switching between two characters. There is this one character that we have seen. This is some sort of killer, and there is a detective, and it kind of bounces between them. So basically it's one line of the plot with the detective, and the other is the killer. It kind of goes as this you know, switching timeline. One thing happened, and the other thing is after, when detective tries to find what happened. That's basically how it starts, and then of course stuff happens. I didn't see all of it, because I just saw one version of the movie, so I didn't see all the scenes, but I saw one version of it based on my choices. So what's the quality? I liked it personally. I think it's Russian. I'm not entirely sure, but I think it's Russian. The original language is Russian, but it has dubbing and pretty well done English. All the stuff is there. There is sound, there is music, there is normal sounds of the movie, plus the talking, right, the dialogue, and you have, you can have subtitles, right? Yeah, subtitles. So yeah, you can change the language of subtitles, you can change the language that's spoken, and it's between Russian and English. I guess there is more subtitles than that, so it's quite nice if you don't know Russian. It's an action movie, right? So if you like something else like horror or sci-fi or something like that, then of course you're not gonna get it. It's just an action movie, but it's done pretty well. It's not very long, because you know, one sequence is just 30 minutes. So that's the whole movie that you will see, and you will then be seeing credits. So it's a short movie, but it's quite well done. I would say it's quite professionally done. Of course, you know, you're not gonna see some stuff like in John Wick or some, you know, Avengers movie, but it's done pretty well, I would say, from the cinematography point of view. The problem is the length, right? And if you definitely want to buy a movie, because basically you're buying a movie that, well, you'll see it and that's it, right? If at best you maybe see it four times, so you're gonna play for like 2 hours, unless you're gonna repeat the same scene, which makes no sense. So this is between 30 minutes and 2 hours of gameplay. That's the whole thing. You can pretty much finish it before the refund time expires. However, I do like that stuff. It's not that I buy it, because it's not worth the time that you get. You know, if I was to pay for a movie, I would just pay for a movie in the cinema. But it is well done. It is definitely a nice experience. If you're willing to pay or not, that's another question. But I did like it. I did like the plot, the story, the acting. It was quite cool. But this is quite specific sort of a game, right? Choosing. Actually, I've seen one movie that had that option. It was Final Destination on a CD, and it actually had options. You could pick an option when watching a CD. I mean, a real CD that you rent. So I've had it done before in something that wasn't a game. So that's why I don't really treat it as a game. It's more like an experience, a cinematic experience than a game. Of course, yes, you make choices. Kind of like in, I always forget this. There's this one game about a girl who is a photographer, and pretty much always, Life is Strange, yes, I always forget it. So Life is Strange is tons of options, tons of changes, and it's not done by actors, it's done by animation, right? And there is just choice after choice after choice, and it's very long. And this is short, but in exchange you get full action movie with actors. So that's the difference, but it kind of works similarly, right? You just pick a version, and then something happens. You know, you like go left, or you go right, or you hide, or you don't, and so on. So basically you pick a sequence and you watch that sequence. I would give it 7, because I like the movie, and it's nice that it has more than one option, not just one movie, it's actually a couple of versions, so choices matter, but it's very little content. It's in terms of, is it worth money? Well, probably not for 2 hours, right? I would pay 50 cents for it. but it is a fun experience if you want to afford it, if you want to pay for it. I would definitely wait for sale with this, but I have to give it above average because they really did a nice job with the movie. Of course, if you can accept action movie, I don't personally very much like action movies. I would prefer something like horror or short sci-fi movie or, well, something like that. Not fantasy maybe, but not necessarily action movie. But it is quite well done, I must say. They put some heart and some work into it. But it's really hard to treat it as a game. You can, of course, treat it as a game, but I personally treat it more like a cinematic experience. Can I recommend it? You have to really be careful about the price. I would say if you want to pay for something like this, sure. It should be nice experience and pretty well done movie. But if you want to get an actual gameplay, if you want to spend your money and then enjoy the game for hours, for like 50 hours or more, then definitely that's not this case. But yes, I can recommend it if you like movies. If you are interested in cinematography, if you can afford it, then sure. If you want to support the developer, that would be a nice tip for his movie, because you know it's like buying a ticket for an indie movie or something like that. And I guess that's it. I don't want to spoil it too much. I'm not even showing you the gallery, just so that you can see what kind of action there was. So the 30 seconds was there, and I treat it positively. It's above average, I would say. It's well done. For what it is, for some sort of indie team of filmmakers. They're probably not very, I'm not sure how professional they are, but I don't think they had a very big budget on this. It's also kind of in enclosed space, so probably they cut the cost on this, but there's some stunts done, so well, that's quite okay. I like the actors, generally speaking, the way they acted, especially the voice actors, because I was watching in English, so I'm not sure how it was in original, but I like the English version. I might replay it, but I would definitely have to have this option to skip, because otherwise it's just too time consuming to go through the same sequences all the time until you can make a different choice, and basically you would have to draw yourself some sort of tree of choices and check all iterations if you want to beat all the endings and see all the achievements, or beat the achievement or get the achievement, see the endings, whatever you call it. So there is a chance you will just be replaying same stuff all the time, and you just have to know, go somewhere, or I'm not even sure if it pauses. I don't think it pauses. I think you have to make the choice. We have to pretty much sit there and watch the same cutscene until you can make a choice, which is annoying. So definitely it needs skipping. It needs basically to be treated as a visual novel, so you can do all the skipping and rewinding and fast forwarding to the moment of choice. This is a standard in a visual novel, so it should be also standard here. So I'm gonna leave you with that. That was She Sees Red. I give it 7 out of 10 because I like the work done and I like the movie. However, you have to be very careful here because it's a very short experience, even below refund price, so you just have to make a decision if you want to spend money on this or not. But it was pleasant experience. It wasn't a bad movie. It was a good movie, but a bit overpriced, I would say. So I'll see you guys next review, hopefully with an actual game, because this was more like a movie, but a good one. So see you guys next time.